My name is Lynn Minard. I'm a lecturer in tourism in the Faculty of Economics, Business and Law.
It's Louise Lawton, and I'm the Exchange Coordinator for the Faculty of Business, Economics and Law.
I'm Dr. Alf Crossman from the Surrey Business School.
Deborah Edwards, I'm the Exchange Administrator at the Faculty of Management, Economics and Law.
Glyn Stevington, and I'm a Senior Tutor in the Department of Biochemistry and Physiology. And in addition, I'm the Programme Director for the MSc in Pharmaceutical Medicine here at the University of Surrey.
My staff exchange was with Lyon in France, University of Lyon 2.
Linköping University in Sweden.
Madrid to the University of San Pablo Theo within the Faculty of Pharmacy there.
La Rochelle Business School in France for my staff exchange.
University of Nicosia in Cyprus. And more recently going to Linköping University in Sweden.
I took part in an Erasmus training exchange.
Teaching exchange.
The main objectives for the visit was to get to know La Rochelle Business School a little bit better, get to know the people that I'm in contact with there, and to find out ways that we could promote mobility between the two institutions.
One was to actually sort of engage with my colleagues at the University of San Pablo Theo in Madrid in terms of observing how they organise, deliver and assess their courses. But secondly, to pass on the expertise we have here at the University of Surrey in respect to small group teaching in terms of the areas of pharmacogenomics.
To shadow my colleagues in the Faculty of Arts and Sciences and to find out how they do their jobs in Linköping.
I undertook 5 hours of teaching, which is the minimum requirement for an Erasmus exchange.
My teaching assignment was 12 hours, spread over 4 days, and it was all in English.
For me, it was about realising how they organise their courses, they deliver their courses, they assess their courses in terms of the large number of students that they have compared to the UC here at the UK universities.
Getting to know my contacts, and also there was a conference taking place at La Rochelle Business School, so I was able to attend some seminars that were related to outgoing mobility and learn about ways to promote that.
Getting exposure to a different style of teaching, getting exposure to more adventurous research. I think the students tend to be much more risk-taking there than they are here. They did things which were novel. They'd got access to local companies in Linköping, so the likes of Ericsson. And the opportunity to work with Swedish colleagues was interesting.
For me, it was really an intercultural shock almost, if you like, because it showed me how differently I had to approach the topic in a non-Anglo-Saxon setting. So it was really refreshing to see how people responded differently to my lectures in France than they do over here, how they ask different questions, etc. So I thought it was really good because it kept me on my toes and it refreshed my thinking about certain issues a bit.
Interestingly, most of the students on the programme that I was supervising on were international, many of them Erasmus exchange students. Most of the faculty in Linköping are Swedish, some from Norway, but all Scandinavian. So this gave the opportunity to bring international faculty into that particular school. And the international students really valued overseas academics coming to teach them and supervise them.
I think the students really enjoyed me being there because I was teaching in English. They get some of their lectures in English, but they appreciated, I suppose, a more native speaker accent. And I also think that I was telling them something about tourism in their own country, but from a foreign perspective, which they wouldn't get with their own lecturers, because they look at French tourism from a French perspective. So a lot of the feedback was that they found it also quite an intercultural shock to hear about social tourism from a British perspective.
I would say my experience was interesting, inspiring and refreshing.
My experience was intercultural. It was very cold because I went in January, but it was mainly great fun.
It was a unique opportunity and I've learned so much from it. And the spin-off has been remarkable because since going on those visits, I've built really strong relationships with that university. I now go back for a month a year to teach a course for them. I developed the course over there and I've now introduced it back here at the University of Surrey on a master programme. So, you know, I've got a lot out of it. The students here have got something out of it as well.
The Erasmus funding covered my staff exchange.
The Erasmus funding covered everything, my travel, my accommodation, and even some of the daily expenses.
It was very good in terms of actually being able to claim all your expenses back.
The budget is tight, but it's very, very doable. I wasn't left out of pocket, and neither was the school.
All you need to do is follow the advice from the International Relations Office staff and also the University Office finance people.
I think Erasmus is a really valuable programme.